that's not exactly what we planned, because Daniel will be the next up. I have the honor to be the first one presenting a showcase, and I will talk about hosting what Carsten just said earlier. My name is Johannes. I'm working at G-Base Media, the company running T3M, and I will show you something about running Neos or Flow in a Kubernetes cluster. Those showcases are cut down to 50 minutes, so I have to rush a bit and hope the pointer will work. Daniel, it's not my pointer. Ich habe keine Ahnung. Ah, a classic. Okay, what is this showcase about? Basically, it's about three small questions. The first is, why did we move at all? To say it before, we did move. We are now in the cloud. And how do we manage and deploy our applications today? Is some special? And what do you need if you want to start today to go in the cluster? What kind of tools do you need? What kind of things you have to do? What we had before. Before we moved to the cloud, T3N was hosted on three basic root servers, powered with some load balancing stuff. And we do not only run T3N. We have like 10 other smaller systems running in the background. Some aren't exposed into the public, running our internal stuff and everything. And that was more or less mixed in the wild on small Jiffy boxes, whatever. So we had a bunch of machines. And we deployed and provisioned with Ansible and Ansible Tower. I'm not sure if anyone is familiar with this, where you can create some walls and everything. And it was kind of, yeah, it does work, but it's not so much fun in the daily business to work with. But what we already achieved last year was we had a complete dev setup in Docker images. So we were pretty comfortable with this, that the move would be quite easy. So why did we, why did we move at all? First point is scaling. Scaling is for us an important point because we have some slots at the day in the morning, for example, when we have a lot more traffic than on the midday, so we can independently scale parts of the application. It's pretty easy today for us to kickstart new small projects. It's kind of a pattern. We think, hey, if we have a small idea, let's kickstart a small Flow project and host it somewhere. And with Kubernetes on our cluster, it's pretty easy to do so. It supports kind of a microservice pattern. And what's really important is, Carsten said it before, today we are running the same Docker images in production as in development. It's cool to say, hey, we develop in Docker images, but running them in production, the same images, is quite a different story. We choose Kubernetes for our container orchestration because it's some kind of the most fancy one and really in development speed quite good, baked by Google. And today, so everything fits in a single cluster. So we don't have like 10 or 15 server out there and there's one we didn't forget about it. Everything is in a single cluster. Actually, today we run three cluster, one for production, one for staging, and one for some smaller internal CI stuff. So if you choose to go, we choose to go with Kubernetes. Kubernetes itself is a really grateful piece of software. You have to get your finger on it and try it out. But Kubernetes needs a lot of configuration. If you want to deploy something in it, you have to define like 5-6 YAML files, whatever. And doesn't make so much fun to do it. So it's kind of a lot of work to do it by hand, actually. So when you start doing it, you ask yourself, how do we actually deploy something in the cluster? And then you find Helm. Helm is some kind of a package manager, also made by Google or the Kubernetes team. And it provides so-called charts. You define an application, a chart, and this chart will generate for you all the Kubernetes files and everything you need. And what you actually can do is, you have a values YAML file where you can define some settings like database name or should editor name, whatever. It's your part to define this API, and it reduces the complexity a lot. You just have a CLI tool. You can say, okay, Helm install Neos, for example, and you have a running Neos application in your Kubernetes. So it's much complexity which is gone. But still, the question is, how do you use it in your daily business? We don't want every developer to go on the CLI and run a command to deploy actually a kind of software, a piece of software, because you also have to provide a values YAML file. Oh, come on, this clicker is really... Okay, so we have Kubernetes, we have Helm. Is it enough to actually work in a daily business? For us, not. We have some kind of missing pieces. The most one is an easy management of values and variables you need to deploy. On a stage cluster, you need a different set of variables compared to a production cluster, of course. So how do you handle secrets? What you do is committing a file, but you don't want to commit secrets, especially to your Git versioning. You want to inject them, don't commit them. You want to be able to just switch the variables. And what we wanted is we wanted to manage all application at one place, not shared over different Git repositories. And you want to be able to product owners or developers deploy with a push of a button. So what we did is kind of in our DNA, we tried to create a small application. When we moved, or we decided to move, was like half a year ago, we thought, okay, we need to have something. So we called created a project called Cuba. And you know it, if you Kickstarter with Flow something, it's really fun. Just create some models, create some classes, see a service, a command line controller, and you're almost done with the shit. But the UI is missing, so we just tested it out. And what Cuba basically is a wrapper for Helm. It's kind of a missing UI for Helm. What you can see here is you can structure all your applications in project groups. It's just really for structure stuff. And if you go in a project group, you can select a project itself. And what we now see is the single view of a project. You can define values. All these values are passed down to each deployment. A project itself is more or less mapped to a chart. And the deployment itself is kind of a mix of a chart deployed in a different namespace on a specific cluster. So we basically have two deployments, live and stage, which will be cluster one, cluster B, in different namespaces. And you can easily manage all those values. On the deployment view itself, what you can see is we have a push of the button to actually start a deployment. We support webhooks, so your continuous integration software can just trigger this webhook and it's deployed. You also see the current cluster status of all your running application and pods. It's a live API Kubernetes fetching stuff, so you always see if is something down or is your deployment good. Because it's a rolling update, it takes some time. If we, for example, for the main page, we have 10, 15 pods, for example, it takes some time because Kubernetes is a rolling update, you always see your cluster status. What we also have is small dashboards. You guys can say, yeah, I need this deployment on dashboards. So these kind of things are in our office. We have three or four of them. And you just see, okay, something goes red, what is up? You see, okay, two pods are down. Can just look into it. It's pretty easy to just define a dashboard with always your live cluster status. So Cuba, the current state, we had to kind of rush to kickstart this project. What you can do actually today is manage all your secrets and variables. Secrets are encrypted and everything is down in your database, so you can really make backups of everything. You can manage several cluster configuration or the Google Cloud authentication is no problem. You could also add your Minikube, whatever, or a different cluster. You can add multiple chart repositories. On Helm charts, there are public chart stuff like Helm provides. You can create your own private charts repositories and add those. We have separation of projects and deployments, so we really have like 20, 30 projects in it and deploy it to different places. For example, you have in Cuba Elasticsearch. Oh, okay, you need Elasticsearch. Yeah, no problem. Create a new deployment and you have a running Elasticsearch in a cluster. When you're at this point, it's really fun. Hosting can be fun, but it's still some work to do. You can configure your dashboards. You can also trigger jobs. We have some indexing jobs, for example. You can just play here, this job should be triggered. A pod will be spawned in the cluster. A flow command is executed. When it's done, the pod will go down and everything is done. And we also have webhooks integrated to just trigger in a deployment. What you can expect, first of all, we will publish it on GitHub. But we have some stuff to do. We also want to add some kind of an audit log. You can see who really managed or changed a variable. to have some kind of a history. We're working on a new fresh UI. The thing you just seen is just some from ThemeForest, whatever. Well, we just wanted to kickstart really, really fast. We are currently working on a new fresh UI based on React and some GraphQL APIs. Some more improved editing experience. We just want an inline YAML editor or something to make it easy for everything. And an easy way to copy clone full namespaces. We just say, okay, I need a copy of my stage and check out another branch, for example. You can just spin it up. And it will be published on GitHub. This is one part. This is more the infrastructure part, what we need on tools to manage the cluster. But we had some lessons learned, and I'd like to point out one of the most important for us. First of all, we tried. Try out is really a good thing. Check Minikube, you can create a cluster local, no problems, just get in touch with this technique. We learned a lot. We're pretty happy right now with our current stack because it really feels fancy, kind of. It's so easy to add new services, whatever. Running applications at scale has some special requirements. If you have 10 pods, 10 instances of your Flow or Neos, you really got some pitfalls. The biggest one probably will be the question, when is your application ready to serve traffic? If a pod is going down, why ever, and another pod is spawning, when should be Kubernetes point traffic to it? Because Kubernetes also, when you're running a deployment, is making a rolling update by default. You can, there are some tricks to go by side, but if you have 10 instances, and an 11th one will be spawned, and as soon as this one is ready, another one will shut down, and then a rolling update. We created a package and we call it JBase Readiness. It's kind of a really good helper to check your ready status. What it does is basically it offers a simple flow command, flow app is ready, and it will return true or false, for example, if your application is ready or false. And what you do is you define some test chains. We have two chains, a test chain and a ready chain. A test chain is something every time will be executed once you run this command. So put in there some ping commands. Is Redis available? Is Elasticsearch reachable? Is your doctrine up to ready? Could be connected. This is the thing. All the services you always need to be there to run your applications. On the other hand, there's a ready chain. Ready chain is meant to be once in a deployment. Doctrine migrate, for example, would be something in there. Resource publish would be in there, but if you're running a cluster, you are stateless, so your buckets, you will have a Google bucket where your stuff is in, but you should publish your static collection with your CSS, whatever, and those are in your container, so you need it to do it. This package has some integrated log management, so you can, the chain won't be executed twice, but you can set this log to Redis, for example, so it will be only once per deployment, or some tasks will be once in every pod. It's some special. So it's really easy to use. It has a lot of configuration options. It's already online on GitHub. You can use it. You could also use it for deployer, serve, whatever. But it's just an easy tool to make sure your application is live. And it's a perfect fit for the Kubernetes readiness and liveness probe. The readiness probe is something you can configure on your service. And when this one is good, Kubernetes will serve traffic. So actually, this is for the ready chain. And the liveness probe is Kubernetes will every 30 seconds or 60 seconds configurable ping this command, and if everything is green, it's good. If not, it will shut down the container or just don't put the traffic on it. You could also use this application for some maintenance stuff or something. If you just want no traffic on this, or you're starting a long working in progress job, whatever, say, no, the app is not ready, so no traffic will be on it. We don't have much time. What can we do to help you to get started? First of all, check our GitHub account. We have quite a lot on it right now, but we will put a lot more on it. What we did 2 days ago, we published all our Docker images, a basic Nginx Docker image, on top a Neos production image and everything. We also got a repository Helm charts. We do host an open Helm chart repository with a basic flow chart. So what you can do today is Helm install /neos demo or flow, and you have a running flow application in your Kubernetes cluster. It's not meant to use to be for production, but as a demo. And we also created a Neos demo application. It's a Docker image hosted by Quarry, and you can deploy it with this chart in your cluster, and you have a running demo, Neos demo. We will add some more applications over time. For example, Kuba will be there, so you can just install Kuba via Helm in your own cluster and can use it. As also with our single sign-on server, we also plan to add it there. If you have some flow applications which are kind of general, make a pull request for the chart, put it in there, and so we have some kind of an open flow Kubernetes chart repository. The Neos Kubernetes demo is just a flow application with a product structure we use today and we use with our charts just for some best practices, and we will also keep to improve those. The UBS readiness package also. Last few words, then I'm done. We are almost at the point to publish a small blog. We want to publish a small developer blog on T3N, and we will document some more insights from our stuff and what you can expect, and some step-by-step tutorials. How do I create an account on Google, create a cluster? How do I use all these tools and everything? So have an eye on this. And the last question, who should actually use it? Carsten said it for you. It's not so much fun about hosting, and actually it's quite some work. I hope those tools will help you to make it easier. But if you if you only got a small application on your site, that's probably not the way to go. But if you have to, if you wanna, sure, go for it. But if you just have a site running, probably Beach or something else would be the better fit. But if you have a large application or a lot of applications talking to each other, or just want to run your own cluster because you have other software, this might be a good helpful tool for you. Thank you.